What is up, guys? It's Cal, and in this video, we're going to be talking about 8.2.5. So, 8.2 just came out. Well, it came out a little over a month ago, but we already have some knowledge on 8.2.5. So remember, since 8.2.5 is a 0.5 patch, there's going to be no new major content, like no new areas to explore, just some minor things. Now, we were first told some stuff about 8.2.5 way back at last year's BlizzCon, and what they told us was that Worgen and Goblins are getting new models, and they are. So, here are some pictures. They look nice. It's more polygons and pixels and all that, so there's that. But what else do we have coming in 8.2.5? Well, it's going to be WoW's 15th anniversary, so there's some cool things coming with that, like a little Nefarian pet. It's adorable. Then there will also be a unique 9-boss raid that can be accessed through Raidfinder. These 9 bosses have pretty much been data mined through voice lines by Chromie, which I'll play in a second, but they are as follows. There's Archimonde from Mount Hyjal, Kael'thas from The Eye, Lady Vash from Serpentrine Cavern, Anub'arak from Trial of the Crusader, Lich King from Icecrown, Hygel the Unclean from Naxx, Cho'Gall from Bastion of Twilight, Nefarian from Blackwing Descent, and Ragnaros from Firelands.
Heroes like you ascended Mount Hyjal to defend Nordrassil against the Burning Legion. In the crystalline halls of Tempest Keep, Azeroth's heroes confronted Kael'thas Sunstrider, Lord of the Blood Elves, and also his 4 advisors, and his 7 legendary weapons, and, you know, let's just get to the fight. Deep within Serpent Shrine Cavern, Lady Vash and her Coil Fang minions plan to steal all of Outland's water. But brave heroes like you weren't about to let that happen. The Argent Crusade once held a grand tournament to find Azeroth's greatest heroes. But Anub'arak arrived uninvited. Amidst Northrend's frozen wastes, the champions of the Argent Tournament laid siege to Ice Crown Citadel. After vanquishing countless minions of the dead, our heroes stood ready to face the wrath of the Lich King. Clever and devious, Hagen the Unclean set up the halls of Naxxramas to poison unprepared adventurers. But dirty tricks like that wouldn't work on you, would they? From within the sinister Bastion of Twilight, Cho'Gall commanded his servants to usher the old gods into our world. Thankfully, heroes like you took up arms and fought the maniacal cult leader face to face. Nefarian, son of Deathwing, was raised from death by Twilight cultists in the heart of Black Rock Mountain. Intrepid heroes such as you braved the Black Dragon Sanctum to put an end to his schemes once and for all. Though thwarted by mortals once before, Ragnaros returned to Azeroth and sought to consume it in flame. It was up to heroes like you to venture into the Firelands and permanently snuff him out.
Defeating all 9 bosses will give you the Obsidian Worldbreaker mount that resembles Deathwing a bit. It's a very cool looking mount in my opinion. Honestly, I really like it. Then on top of that, there will be a new old school inspired Alteric Valley battleground that players can queue for. And from it, you can get a new anniversary currency that can be exchanged for 2 mounts, a Stormpike Battle Charger for the Alliance and Frostwolf Snarler for the Horde. I'm not too sure if getting one will automatically get you the other or if you have to do the battleground on both factions to get both mounts. But needless to say, when the 15th anniversary comes, which is from November 16th to November 30th, I'll be making a video over it and everything you're able to do. Next up is the B mount. Yes, we finally get the B mounts that we've actually seen in the past before. Well, Alliance get the B mount. Though if you main Horde, you can of course get it on an Alliance tune and use it on your Horde tune. It makes sense since Horde have like 1 or 2 exclusive mounts, I think. Now, the specifics on getting this B mount haven't been confirmed, but there's just some series of quests in Stormsong Valley that will lead to it. Then there's a Time Walking Firelands raid, which is cool of course. We have Time Walking Black Temple, then Time Walking Old War, now Time Walking Firelands. So I assume you probably want to get all those achievements in Firelands, because just like Old War, they'll all become feats of strength. Now, something interesting that they're going to be implementing onto the PTR to test out before live servers is something called Party Sync. So this is a few features to it. If your party leader enables party sync, then everyone in the group will be aligned to the same quest state, including phases, and you can mouse over the quest to see what people's progress on it is and who can turn in the quest. Now this party sync feature will also give a replay option for quests, allowing players to actually replay quests they've already completed, so they can play more with their new friends who are joining the game. And these replay quests will still give rewards appropriate for their current level to the player who's replaying that quest. I don't know how I feel about this one, but it's not over yet. Now, party sync will also allow high level players to queue for dungeons with their lower level friends. It will just scale their level down, so there's more scaling stuff. Now, this scaling is different than time walking, since it will actually take away your higher level abilities, including Azeroth traits, if your level is scaled down. I don't know, it's new. So you can leave your comments on what you think about Party Sync in the comments below, but I'm not done. There's Recruit a Friend, it's coming back of course. Now this Recruit a Friend is different than past ones. Well, I mean it works the same where you're given a link that you can give to a friend, they can pay with the game time through that link and you get rewards. But guys, this is different. So if someone uses your Recruit a Friend link and pays for game time, you'll get rewards for every month that they play. These rewards will be toys, pets, and of course mounts. But yeah, as the months go on, you'll get unique rewards from them paying their money to Blizzard. These rewards aren't specific, they just said pets, toys, and mounts. Anyways, moving on. That's almost everything, pretty much everything. Rathion and Valyra are getting new models, so that's cool, right? This is of course going to set up for 8.3 when we go to the Dragon Isles. Well, Valyra doesn't really have to do with the Dragon Isles, I don't think, but Rathion definitely does. So that will be interesting. Oh, and hunters are getting a new glyph in 8.2.5 called Glyph of Direbeast, which turns your Direbeast stability into Direbeast. So, it's too bad Direbeast sucks. Anyways guys, that's just quickly some new things coming in 8.2.5. I'll try to hop on the PTR to get some footage of anything that's worthwhile, so make sure to subscribe for that. But that's the entire video guys. Feel free to leave in the comments on any of your favorite features, especially that party sync one. I don't know how I feel about that one, but if you guys enjoyed this video, then feel free to leave a like on it. You can sub to the channel for more videos like this, and I'll see you guys in the next video.